All right, here we go. Jesse Johnson, Scott Vogelsberg, straight race to 7. This is a one-loss side match. Looks like Tim Daniel just beat Dave Mark over there. That would have been a winner's side match, so Dave is still in it. One of each. Hello, Larry DeWitt. Ten on the side. That leaves him with the 9 to figure out. Nope. Not exactly the way he wanted to get things started.
Whoa.
He doesn't have to like that. Said it all weekend. I don't like leaving that 9 ball for last. Of course, when you shoot that good, can get perfect on the ball. He's following it. I sure liked draw there a lot better. And it also seemed like he rushed it once he got down on him. Good shot there. 1-0 Scott Vogelsberg. Scott seems to, you know, he takes his time to figure out what he wants to do, but then when he's made up his mind, he just gets down and, I'm not sure I would call it a one stroke. He's just got to figure out this four ball. He can come across right here. Just like that. 7-6-8. Not happy with it. Okay, that's why he wasn't happy with it. He knew he was going to bump the eight. Still cut this ball in. Or not. Okay, he's just trying to put him up on the eight. Good shot. Sure, he can hit anything directly. I think he has to kick for anything. And I would be wrong. Took the pocket over, but Scott's got so much in front of it. I'm not sure how effective that's going to be. Didn't look like that ball had to go in. I'm not sure I care for this shot. That's why. Didn't have any kind of control of his cue ball there. You're rolling up and back 14 feet. Nice shot. Nice two-way shot there. That's a good shot. Jesse's going to have to really come up with something to leave him safe. Maybe you just go for it here and try to bank it back. Well, maybe that's not what he's doing. It looked like he was calling the bank back to his left. Get him on the 7? No. Ooh. All right, Scott Vogelsberg, 2-0. Seven, seven. In case you couldn't hear Chuck in the background there, we are doing the raffle. Custom Peach RQ. Well, production Peach RQ, but still. Brand new set of Aramith balls. if you're watching the stream and you want to get involved, houseprobillards.com on PayPal, and then drop me a note and tell me what you sent the money for, and I'll take care of it. That works. Problem here is now going to be the 13. He's got a little bit of angle here. Get out far enough? Oh, it looks like he did, yeah. He's just gonna bump the five. Okay, no, he's still got the angle on this 13. Too far, and he's going to end up losing his shape on the eight. It looks like he's trying to draw over to the side and back. Okay, he's not going to like this. Interesting tower of chalk there. This is a tough shot. All right, now that's not a loss. Just ball in hand for Scott. Thank you. far. Got a bump. Nice bump there. Not as good a shot there. Excuse me. Good shot there from Jesse. He needed that. Ball in hand. Solids look awfully good here. Sure what he's got here. Okay. Jesse just has to navigate this. There's nothing tied up. Good shot there. Kept him from bumping into those balls. Brady, the brackets are on leaguepoolstats.com. Okay, that worked out for him. Still got to get up there for that 13 ball. You are very welcome. It's not what he had in mind. He knows it too. he's getting himself in trouble. And every ball he makes is just making the trouble bigger. Unless he can come up with some miracle shot here. Cut the ball in, go back and forth across the table with draw. Kind of like that. At least he got that ball back over near the two ball. Just make one more complication for Scott to deal with. Safety. It in the bottom right corner. How'd he hit it? Wow. I thought that ball was in the hole. I still think the 8 clears that ball though. So Scott's got this one. He just needs to convert it. I mean, there's nothing difficult here. That's going to cost him a game. Didn't try to do too much with it, just settle for the 8 down. Or up, actually, I guess. 2-2. Oh, it's hard to tell. It's the sunglasses.
Yeah, that's how we tell the difference, Scott. I'm wearing glasses.
Good. he's following this. Okay, that worked out. It'll help him get up table. Follow to the rail and back to the right for the nine, or he can just draw over. He's following. I was thinking he could have bumped the four, but it didn't hurt him. Almost went too far. Scott Vogelsberg began to the lead, 3-2. There's an ugly table. And that didn't make it much better. Nice shot. Looked like a one pocket player there, taking that pocket over. Expected a slightly better breakout than that. And didn't get much separation there. A little better separation there. He's just not going to like where he's at. Nope, meant to make that three. That might cost him a game. Can't tell if the six goes by the eight. That's what he's looking at now. If it doesn't, then he can clear out the 5-2 and then bank the six back. It might go now. Oh, well, actually, it probably goes in the corner.
Came up.
Two, six, 5-4, or not. Way too far there. Now he's digging himself a deeper and deeper hole. He's got to be careful. He kicks this wrong, he makes the eight. If he kicks to make this ball and goes a little too far, well, and if he hits it perfect, okay. He might have taken that pocket away too. He's addressing this like the ball goes, 13 ball. Oh, he was trying to play safe, and that was awful. Oh, he just didn't expect he was going to hit the 14. Like that. From here, it does not look like the eight goes in the side. And I think if it did, he'd have shot this ball already. Did he hit that ball too hard? Yes, he did. He hit it real good and had the right idea. He's not jumping. He's gonna have to come up with some kind of crazy kick shot. Tough shot. Mm-hmm. sure which he got first here. I think he got the eight. He got rail eight. He's actually supposed to have given up ball in hand here. Brady, I'm with you there. The only reason I knew it was a bad hit is because I've also got a tablet here, so I'm watching it when it displays on Facebook, and I was able to go back and look. It looked like it went rail, and then the ball. It's not going to matter, though. Jesse's out. Free drinks, but stand in front of the men's room.
Quite a few, actually. They actually moved to the end. He said that he had a really good UFC. Pool players didn't spend very much money, but UFC did. He said he did really well.
I like the stripes here, but that two ball is going to be a problem. Looks like the nine goes in the side. Something with that two sooner than later. Maybe he's going to shoot the 15 into the corner off the 2. That was the idea.
Yeah.
told that our next match is Bill Vanderweist and Joe Guerra. Well, yeah, this used to be a Walgreens. Did they didn't do deliveries there. Oh, yeah. One rail kick for the 15. Yeah. It was there, of all places. Yeah. Well, he got the hit, he got a rail. You know, it's probably not going to hurt him, but it just seems like he's going from ball to ball here with no overall plan. Wasn't going to make the eight, but came up a little far. He'll still be okay. We're going back and forth here. Scott back in the lead. 4-3. Surprised. Everybody seems to have one. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Is that what Shane was talking about the other day? People were asking him what shaft he was using. Oh, wow. Yeah. Alright, he made the eight on the break there, and that gave him the option. He didn't like the way the table looked, so he can re-break.
I
think it's just going to put Johan in an interesting position. I mean, does Johan treat him like any other player and say, look, if you're not going to play the game, then you're not on the team? Or does Johan just say, okay, yes, you are who you are and you still make the team? I thought he said he just didn't want to play the, didn't want to do the boot camp thing. Oh, wow. And what I read was a little, yeah. Yeah. Wow. That's a nice shot. He ran a little far. Paul, the score's right in front of you. Scott 4, Jesse 3, race to 7. What the deal is with the 3-1? He's gonna hit it. Okay, that worked out great. No worries, Paul. Good. 8 in the side. And we'll be tied again. Oh, okay. Played that a little different than I thought. It'll work out either way. Tied again.
for the extra match.
Yeah. Well, it happens.
It's not going to be 4 a.m.
We might have still been here if we had played that other match last night.
Yeah, I probably wouldn't have gone home. I would have just stuck in my truck.
Trying to wind up so he could get shape on that two ball. I can't tell if the two ball goes by. And now, I don't think the 12 ball goes by the 8. A little far. Well, okay, this might work. Yes, it will. I think this might be Jesse's first lead here. Sure.
And it's over by the ice machine. If it doesn't work, then walk over by the ice machine.
Okay.
Okay, Google lights on. And then let's, and then okay, Google lights on.
Okay.
There's also, in the ceiling, there's a white thing. On the side of it, there's a button.
Oh, yeah, that's so, cool.
Yeah, but yeah, just okay, Google lights on.
Matt, we are in the final 12. So losers here take 9th through 12th. Who's ahead over there? Ed? Oh, okay. That doesn't surprise me. And I'm sure it's the other guy. And I'm sure it's the other guy slowing things down. It's always the other guy. Looks like the 10 passes the 5, and if so, then I think that's a good ball to use to get on the 8. He should be out here. Should be tied 5-5. Doesn't want to be on the rail. That worked out all right. Tied again. A ball. Still things to worry about down here. Oops. I'm not positive if that 13 goes by. Looks like it does. Or he may take the 14. No, jacking up on the 13, a lot straighter. Didn't even look like he tried to avoid bumping it. I care for this. Not like he has a whole lot of other options. Looks good. Oh no. He got the shape he wanted. That works. Like he's calling the one rail kick in the top right. Again, he's going to like the leave. Thank you. left him a one-rail bank. One-rail bank on the two. He's called it. I haven't been changing camera angles a lot. My laptop is... No, it must not have. I thought he called it. He went too far there. Wow. By a mile. There's no reason at all to give up that straight a shot, that easy a shot, when you've got three balls left and your opponent has one. Especially at 5-5. Scott Vogelsberg on the hill. Is it, Matt? Seems to me like we had to zoom out too far for that side angle, but hey. All right, we can go here for a while. Okay, works for me. Did not open up his 11, but it did open up his 13-9. Actually, I take that back. Okay, yeah, never mind. That opened up the 11. I think it goes in the corner, though. Maybe I spoke too soon. Maybe it's not open. Okay, that's two votes for. Good shot. Sure looks like he can make the 11. I'm not going to say on this shot, but it sure looks like he can make it now, get by the 7. You may be right, he may be out. Well, it definitely goes now. If he wasn't jacked up on the 7, he might shoot the 9 past the 8. The pattern is a whole lot easier if you do that. Nope, not gonna matter. I'm not switching angles back. He's going to have to move Whitey a little bit here. And he did. He got where he needed to be. Scott for the win. Ooh. There you go, Scott Vogelsberg, 7-5 over Jesse Johnson. We will be back with winner's side action, Bill Vanderweist and Joe Guerra here in just a minute.